All right, guys, so I hope you've been playing around with classes a little bit and have figured some stuff out about it that maybe I haven't mentioned. If you come from another programming background, then that's most likely going to be the case, and you probably have a pretty good idea on how to do numerous things involving classes and objects. For everyone else, and even just as a primer, what we're going to be doing in this video is t extending classes, and this means we're going to subclass them. So I'm going to be creating a new class, a couple new classes that are going to extend the animal class. So when we think about certain animals, let's say there are distinct differences between fish and dogs. For instance, dogs can bark, so they obviously have a bark volume. Dogs wear leashes, so their leash must have a color. And fish swim, so they must have a swim speed, for instance. Now, obviously, these things could be processed in a more vague way, and let's say the swim speed could actually just be called speed because dogs also have a certain speed that they move at. However, for the sake of this video, we're going to be creating two new classes. So let's go ahead and extend the animal class. So how we do that, we type the keyword class. So we're creating a new class. The new class is called dog. Now, in order to inherit all of this from the animal class, we then put extends animal. So there we go. We have a class named dog. Now, I'm getting sick of these warnings. I'm probably going to try a different code editor at some point to see if we can get these to go away. So basically, what we do here is we're going to create a constructor and it's going to take all the same data and then some. So let's go ahead and create the constructor method. So we're going to take name, height, weight, bark volume, and leash color. So at this point, in order to instantiate this object as an animal and have access to all these properties and methods that are in the animal class, we need to call what's called a super constructor. How we do that is it's a keyword. You just type in super. And in here, essentially, it's the same as writing animal. Okay? So we're going to just pass in the same values that we would pass into the animal's constructor, which would be name, height, and weight. And this is what I mean by I hate these lines. It says superclass constructor invocation should be in constructor body, which is strange because that's exactly where it is. However, I want to make sure that's indented properly. There we go. So then once we get that created, then the dog object that we create has a name, height, and weight. But we're also going to give it a bark volume and leash color. So let's set this dot bark volume equals bark volume, and then this dot leash color equals leash color. So at this point, the dog has a name, a height, a weight, a bark volume, and a leash color. So I'm going to create a method here that we're going to be calling, and let's call it bark. What we're going to do is, de depending on the volume level, which is going to be between 0 and 1, it's going actually 0 and 100. That makes it easier. What we're going to do is, if it's above a certain amount, it's going to bark loudly. Otherwise, it's going to bark quietly. So if it's over 50, it's going to be a loud bark. So if this dot bark volume is over 50, we're going to console log bark bark instead. Let's type the dog barks. Actually, let's use the actual name. So this dot name barks. Hold on. Barks loudly. If it's under 50, we're gonna console log this dot name barks timidly. There we go. So now if we save this and refresh our page, we shouldn't see any errors, but we also shouldn't see anything happen yet. So we actually need to go create, we need to instantiate the dog, and then the dog object or the dog class will go back to the animal class and instantiate that, and then kind of combine them together. So var king equals new dog. We're going to pass in king is the name. Its height, it's a very big dog, so we're going to say it's 45 inches tall. I'm not sure if that's big or not. It's going to be 92 pounds. It's going to have a bark volume of 72 and a leash color of red. And in here, I'm going to put the volume. This dot bark volume there. And I'm just going to copy and paste this into the next line as well. There we go. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say king.bark. So I'm going to save this and refresh it. It says king barks loudly. As you can see, the constructor of the parent class is being invoked here. If I remove this and save it and refresh, as you can see, it's giving us an error. So that's why we need to call the super constructor, and then everything works well. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go extend the animal class again. So I'm going to say class fish extends animal. Now, the same thing in here. We're going to create a constructor. It's going to take in a name, height, weight, and a swim speed. So again, we need to call super with the name, height, and weight. And then we're going to set this swim speed equals swim speed. And then we're going to create a method here called swim. Now, if the swim speed is above 50, he's going to swim around fast. Quickly. So if this dot swim speed is higher than 50, we're going to console log the name. So this dot name swims around quickly. Speed is going to be this dot swim speed. And then we're going to close that. If it's not above 50, we're going to console log this dot name. So it's going to print out the fish's name, put a comma, swims around slowly. And we're going to say speed. It's going to be equal to this dot swim speed. We're going to print that out here. No, I can't use plus signs because that's going to try. Oh, yeah, I can. Should work. I've been working in Python a lot lately, so. What we're going to do now is we're going to create Goldie. It's going to be equal to new fish. The name is going to be Goldie. The height is going to be 2 inches. Weight is going to be 0.1 pounds. I'm not sure if that's reasonable. And the swim speed is going to be 43. And then under the dog barking is going to scare the fish, and so Goldie is going to swim. I'm going to save this and refresh. And as you can see, it says created animal, then King barks loudly, volume 72, and Goldie swims around slowly. Now this, we can give Goldie a better chance of surviving if we make him swim around quickly. So let's go ahead and change the swim speed to 77. Save it and refresh. There we go. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of do a calculation here, and if the swim or if the fish swims quicker than the dog is able to run, and we're going to determine that based on their size, so 45. So we're just going to do a simple comparison here. So in the swim method, we're going to pass in king.height. And then in here, we say chaser height. That's what we're going to pass in there. And if this.swim speed is greater than chaser height, actually, no, let's use speed. Let's give the dog speed too, okay? So he has leash color and speed. And then this dot speed is going to be equal to speed. So we're going to come down here and we're going to give the dog a speed of 52. And we're going to say king dot speed here. So change this to chaser speed. And we're just going to compare the two speeds. So if this dot speed is greater than, sorry, this dot swim speed is greater than chaser speed, we console log the name. So this name got away. Else, we're going to console log was caught. All right, so let's save. Let's go ahead and refresh. What we should have now is a method that says Goldie got away. All right, so King barks loudly, Goldie swims around quickly, and Goldie got away. Now, if we change the speed to less than the dog's speed, so 46, I'm going to save it and refresh. And because Goldie swims around slowly, he is caught. So that was a neat little mini game kind of thing, or little program that we built. That was fun. But as you can see, we can extend animals. We can extend any class, really. We could even extend dog and create a Labrador, if we wanted to. You can continue extending classes and subclasses however far you want. So that was how to extend classes.